What is this dielectric constant? We already heard dielectric means it is an insulator. We use in the capacitor. But what is this dielectric constant? This dielectric constant is nothing but epsilon. Here, the epsilon we are taking, the dielectric constant, we use the different terminologies. Epsilon, epsilon naught and epsilon r. Epsilon is different, epsilon naught is different and epsilon r is different. We will now come to know what is the difference between these three. Epsilon is the original permittivity of a material, where epsilon naught is the permittivity of a free space, or absolute permittivity we call. And epsilon r is the relative permittivity of a material or a dielectric. Why these many permittivities we have to use? If we want to use the dielectric material, a wood, if we simply use epsilon, that is sufficient. Why we are using these many terminologies? We are calling absolute permittivity. Why suddenly free space came? And because we never observe the vacuum in the real time. Vacuum we observe in the space. There is no need to use the capacitive sensor for our application in the space. If we keep a capacitive sensor in the space, we cannot use that here. So for our real-time applications, why we are not bothering about the epsilon, why we are bothering about epsilon naught and epsilon r, what is this epsilon r? Relative permittivity, why it came? If you remember in the previous classes, we discussed, whenever we are measuring the electric field lines, practically, there is no instrument in our laboratory to measure the electric field lines. And even if we want to measure the electric field lines, we can use some sophisticated instruments, but with our laboratory instruments like multimeters, we cannot measure. Only we can measure what is the voltage in this capacitor. We can find the voltage in that capacitor with the instrument we have in the laboratory. Okay, now the question is, the material, the dielectric we are using here, this has a certain amount of permittivity that we already know. That has the ability to store the electric field lines, but we do not know how many electric field lines that is storing. Now, we are asking, okay, leave about the electric field lines. Now, tell me what is the permittivity of this material? Again, the same question we are asking in the fundamental level. Now, if we ask what is the permittivity of this material, there is a problem here. We do not have the absolute value or original value, the original permittivity value of this material. Why we do not have original permittivity value of this material? Because whenever we are taking any material, the ability to allow the electric field lines, whatever we are calling as the permittivity, we are measuring the permittivity with respect to the free space permittivity. If there is a mango tree at your home and that mango tree is giving, example, you are getting 100 mangoes this year. Every year that is giving 100, 100, 100. Now this year suddenly 150 mangoes you observed. Then you say the mango tree gave very good crop this year. How you are saying very good crop? Compare it to 100, 150 is high, sir. Okay, next year only you got 60 mangoes, sir, this year crop is not that much fruitful. How you are saying every year we used to get 100 mangoes, but this year only we got 60 mangoes, sir. But one foreigner came, foreigner means some other place person. He came and he observed what is the crop of this year. And he said, you said 60, only 60 mangoes. Oh, 60 mangoes. 60 means very good number. Then to him, because he never knows the previous yield of the tree, he thinks 60 is very good number. And similarly, when in second year also some other person, some other foreigner came, that year you got the crop yield 150 mangoes. Then he came and asked you, why you are not getting 1000 mangoes or 2000 mangoes or 5000 mangoes? Then you say, compare it to previous years, this is very good crop. This tree does not have the capability to give 1000 or 2000 mangoes. So here we are comparing the original crop value, the original yield, crop yield for every year, that is 100. This is we are calling as absolute permittivity. With comparison to this, we are getting very good result, 150 mangoes. or with comparison to this, we are getting less mangoes, 60. We are using some comparison. If I am standing here in front of the board, if somebody asks me what is your location, simply I share my location to him by using the Google Maps. Then in that location, you will get some longitude and latitude. In this much degree longitude, I am standing. In this much degree latitude, I am standing. But in originality, if I tell this longitude and latitude to him, I am at 87 degrees longitude and 120 degrees latitude, come to this place and call to me. Then that person thinks, where is this longitude and latitude? And you have to mention him, I am here in Government Polytechnic Amdalawalsa. You are changing the longitude and latitude to the original language of the original language to make the other person to understand. This conversion you are making only to make him understand. Similarly, even though we do not have the capability to measure the epsilon, we have the capability to measure the epsilon r. This epsilon r is called as a relative permittivity. With respect to something, you can say, I am here with respect to someone. This A point is some 2 centimeters left to the B with respect to B. But if I ask, tell me the position of A, then you have to start from somewhere infinite in the universe and you have to bring, to find the A, you have to go to somewhere and you will never come back in your lifetime. So, leave about to find what is the distance between A and B or a displacement between A and B. Whenever you want to find, if you want to find what, where A is, actually there is no solution to us to find where the A is, where this chalk piece in this universe, this entire vast universe, only we can find this chalk piece position with respect to the Earth. Only we can find the chalk piece position with respect to something. Always we are measuring the relative measurement. Here also, we are using the epsilon r, which is the relative permittivity. We are measuring with respect to the, we are measuring with respect to epsilon naught. Now, what is this epsilon r? We are calling this as a dielectric constant. The dielectric constant is nothing but epsilon r. Epsilon r. So, epsilon r is equal to epsilon y epsilon naught. Epsilon by epsilon naught. The ratio of original permittivity of a material to the absolute permittivity of a free space. This ratio is called as dielectric constant. Because it is, this value is always constant, we call this as a dielectric constant. But in the capacitance application, we mentioned epsilon A by D. We want to use the epsilon value. How to get the epsilon value? Because we already know epsilon r of a material, if we multiply the epsilon r of this material with epsilon naught, then obviously we will get the epsilon. So practically, even though we do not have the capability to find the epsilon with our instruments, the mathematical product of epsilon r and epsilon naught is giving the epsilon. That epsilon we will substitute here and we will find the capacitance value. This is a dielectric constant.